everybody. This week on The Daily Dose, we're talking about lies. Now, don't panic. These aren't lies we get caught telling. We're not going to put you into confession this week. Think of it more like a lie radar, specifically when it comes to the church. Whether we're a practicing Christian or not, there are certain things that have a way of seeping into our subconscious, ideas we've maybe picked up along the way, we've been told are must-haves for a life of faith. And sometimes we've been led to believe that these things are deal breakers to call ourselves Christian. But this week, we are working with you to dig down into some of those claims. We're looking at the Bible, we are putting on our best lie radar, and we're suggesting that some of these things are lies we've been told about the church. So today, I want to talk with you about one you may have heard, that you need to have a personal relationship with Jesus, that your Christian faith is only as good as the relationship you have with your personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Have you heard that before? Maybe you have, like me. Now, in our lives, there are plenty of personal things we are offered all the time, personal help. You could hire a personal assistant to help you organize everything in your house. Or you could go to a gym and ask for a personal trainer to help you work on some of your training athletic goals. You look for personal space too, right? Sometimes we take a personal day off work to get things done around our house or take a mental health break. And maybe if you're a parent like me, sometimes you just want your personal space away from the 5,000 questions your kids ask you every day. So when it comes to our faith, what is it about getting personal? Each person is different, right? So wouldn't my friend's relationship with Jesus be different than mine? Well, on the one hand, yes, of course, we each approach faith a little differently, and we are drawn to different aspects of faith in our journeys. But I want to suggest to you that the goal of Christianity is not to seek a personal, isolated relationship with Jesus. Instead, it's important for us to practice our Christian faith in community. Or as you may have heard in our sermon at Calvary a few weeks ago, it's more about we than it is about me. Now, look with me for a minute at some key parts of scripture that remind us of this. First of all, Jesus, at the very beginning of his ministry, looks to people like fishermen and tax collectors to be his followers. And we often hear about the 12 disciples who were Jesus's followers. But it's important for us to also hear about Jesus's teaching and miracles that didn't just stop with those 12. For instance, in Luke chapter 9, we read, "When Jesus had called the 12 together, he gave them power and authority to drive out demons and to cure diseases. And he set them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. So they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and healing people everywhere." Jesus presumably did have a relationship with those disciples, but then he sent them out to teach others to continue his ministry, a movement into community. And if I asked you, what's the most famous, well-known prayer that you can think of? I would imagine many of you would say the Lord's Prayer. And think with me for a minute, how does it start? Does it start with, "My Father, who art in heaven"? No, it doesn't, right? We hear that prayer, we say that prayer by starting, "Our Father, who art in heaven." And it's actually kind of interesting if we look in the Bible at the way this passage is taught from Jesus. So listen with me for a minute to Matthew chapter 6. Jesus says, "And when you pray, do not be like hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by others. But truly I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father who is unseen." Now wait a minute, you might be saying, that sounds like a pretty quiet, isolated space to be praying. Yes, it is. So maybe there are times Jesus is saying that solitude is good, but remember, he's also saying this is where we block out the noise. We block out the words of the hypocrites, and we continue to look at what Jesus said through these words. He says, "This is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we have also been forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Now, there are plenty of other places in the Bible where we could read about ways that we are invited into community, where it's about we instead of me. But loop back with me for just a minute to the lie we're talking about in today's Daily Dose, that the goal of faith is not simply to have a personal relationship with Jesus. Because what happens when we are all about our own personal goals, all by ourselves in isolation? Well, then it really does become about me. We put those blinders on. And as tempted as I am to keep working on myself, it can easily become a never-ending cycle. When am I ever good enough for anything? Is my goal to have a better, stronger, more personal relationship with Jesus than my neighbor? I don't think so. God comes to me. God forgives me, no matter how hard I work or how hard I don't work on something. And for me, it's really well summed up in these verses from 1 Corinthians. We hear, just as the body, though one, has many parts, but all its many parts form one body, so it is with Christ. For we were all baptized by one Spirit, so as to form one body, whether Jews or Gentiles, slaves or free, and we were given the one Spirit to drink. Even so, the body is not made up of one part, but of many. So ask yourself today, how can I grow in my faith, surrounded by other people, with that big, beautiful, diverse body of Christ? Thanks so much for watching The Daily Dose today. We'd love for you to subscribe. If you're watching this on YouTube, share it. If you're watching on Facebook, be sure to leave your comments. Let us know what you think about this week's Daily Dose. Thanks so much.